S. Roberts, pastor of Sunnyvale Baptist Church, speaking to you and saying greetings to all of you. We're happy that God has given us another privilege to come your way again by means of radio and to bring you this program. We want to say that we hope that each of you are enjoying a nice Thanksgiving weekend, that you're planning on being in the house of the Lord tomorrow, which is, of course, the Lord's Day. Surely every child of God ought to give the Lord at least one day out of every seven. In fact, God calls upon us to give ourselves wholly and unreservedly unto Him. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present yourselves a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And the Bible says, for us to lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. We want to urge each and every one of you to be in the Lord's house tomorrow without fail. And especially do we want to urge the members of the Sunnyvale Baptist Church and you who attend here to be in attendance. Let's all of us show God we're thankful unto Him for His blessings toward us. You know, the least that we can do is to be present for the services in the church. Our Sunday school here at Sunnyvale begins at 9:45, and the preaching service at 10:50, and the training service at 6, and then the evening preaching service at 6:50. Location of the Sunnyvale Baptist Church is 8427 Waterwood Lane here in the Pleasant Grove area in Dallas. Our singing today was by the group and the quartet. The group song was, "There Shall Be Showers of Blessing," and the quartet number, "Our Thanks to Him." Singing in the quartet, Brother Paul Ritchie singing bass. Today, Brother John Henderson singing the baritone. Brother Flood singing the alto. And I was singing the lead, June at the piano. We'd like to remember our sick folks with these songs. We'd like to remember Brother and Sister Loggins. Sister Loggins just got out of the hospital a few days ago. We'd like to remember Sister Eva White, who's in the East Dallas Clinic at this time. Also like to remember Linda Hicks and Bill, who have a new baby boy. Like to also remember our daughter Nelda, who has another boy. And also Sister Samantha Stevenson, who is recovering from a lengthy illness. Now, our passage of scripture today is found in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, verses 38 through 42. Now, it came to pass as they went that he entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was cumbered about much serving, and came to him and said, Lord, dost thou not care that my sister hath left me to serve alone? Bid her therefore that she help me. And Jesus answered and said to her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things, but one thing is needful, and Mary hath chosen that good part which shall not be taken away from her. Now our subject this morning, the most important things of life. I guess I should say this afternoon, rather. Our subject is the most important things of life. Here we see that Martha was overly concerned about physical food. She cumbered about much serving. But Mary was concerned about the spiritual food. She sat at Jesus' feet and heard the word. Certainly, food for the physical body is important. But the Bible teaches that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Though one might have storehouses full of bread, unless they have spiritual bread, and unless they eat that spiritual bread, they will become poor and sickly and die spiritually. Oh, dear friend, don't place the importance upon the physical, but upon the spiritual. You know, good health is important. Certainly it is. Our bodies are the temples of God's Holy Spirit. We're commanded to keep them in as good condition as we can. We're commanded to take care of them. But let me remind you that the soul is most important. The body goes back to the dust, but the soul never dies. Many people put more stress on the healing of the body than on the salvation of the soul. God has given every individual a soul, and that soul is the individual's responsibility. And that soul at death will go into eternity. It is your responsibility as to where your soul goes. At death, the soul goes to one of two places. There's a heaven for the saved and a hell for the unsaved. What about your soul, dear listener? Have you yielded it to God? The most important thing in all this world is your soul. Jesus asked the question and said, what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Oh, make sure that your soul is saved. Give it to Jesus today if you haven't already done it. John 3:36, he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life. And he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. Yes, there are many important things in the world. You know, material things are important to a point. Know how so many people are striving to gain them. But oh, if one gains the entire world and loses their precious soul, they've lost everything. The rich farmer was prosperous, and he made plans to retire and eat and drink and be merry the rest of his life. But oh, the voice spoke out of heaven and said, thou fool, this night thy soul is required of thee. Life wasn't very long. There are too many people today who are putting the importance on material things, on riches and wealth. Oh, we think of the old rich man in the hell that lifted up his eyes in torments. Had nothing there but pain and agony, misery and sorrow. Many people think that power in this world is most important. So many people are seeking power and prestige in this life, but But beloved, the power of God in one's life is what really counts. And there are some that are seeking popularity. But oh, this is only short-lived. The prodigal son found that out, and multitudes have found it out since then. And oh, how people are seeking the pleasures of the world. Moses chose to suffer affliction with the people of God than enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Dear friend, the important thing is to get saved. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Get saved. And after one is saved, they ought to follow Jesus. There is real joy, happiness in following Jesus. There's a song that said, every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. And truly it is. My friend, you can have happiness in this world. You'll only trust in Jesus Christ. You know, a lot of people are seeking happiness, satisfaction elsewhere, but they fail to find it. The grass is always greener on the other side, and they never get to the end of the rainbow. Well, I'm glad to say unto you this afternoon that the Christian life is the only life. You're saved today. You're falling afar off like old Simon Peter did. We beseech you to come close to Jesus. Get close to him. Dedicate your life to him and to his service. And oh, listen, if you're unsaved, won't you trust in the Lord? Jesus said, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. Won't you trust the Lord Jesus Christ today and be saved? You'll have happiness in this world, and hallelujah, you'll have happiness in eternity there as you bask in the sunlight of God's wonderful love. May the Lord bless you today and help you, is our prayer. Goodbye until the same time next Saturday.